Hello, my name is Kylie, and welcome to How Prices Are Set. In this video, you'll learn about how people who wish to sell a product or service set their prices. Do you have a lot of great ideas or items for sale in your shop? Your shop is one of many competing for sales in our site marketplace. Watching this video may help you set the best prices for your artwork so you can get the most sales and make the most profit. Ready to learn how to set prices? Let's get earning. Before we get into setting prices for things, let's talk a little bit about the people involved in buying and selling. People who make a product or provide a service for sale are called producers. People who buy these items or pay for these services are called consumers. Anyone who buys a product from a producer is a consumer. What is the last item or service you bought? Yesterday, I purchased a service because I got a haircut. You are also a producer if you've designed anything for our marketplace. Have you? If so, congratulations! Do you have any sales? One of the hardest things to do when you want to sell something you've made is deciding the price at which you should sell your item at. How do you decide? Well, here is some information about how setting prices works. There is a system in buying and selling goods and services known as supply and demand. Supply and demand is one of the most important factors in how prices are set. Supply is how much of something is available to buy. Look at this example. Okay, this store has a great supply of canned food. Demand is how many people need or want a good or service. So, look at all these people waiting in their cars to buy gasoline. This shows a high demand. Demand for an item can really affect how that item is priced. For example, the latest toy or music group's t-shirt will be in really high demand. Everyone wants it and they want it now. That high demand can cause the producer to set the prices high because the producer knows the consumer will pay almost any amount to get that item. But if the toy or music group goes out of style and something else comes along, the demand may drop. If that happens, the prices will drop too. Scarcity is when there is not enough of the product to go around to the consumers. One great example of scarcity is any natural resource like oil, coal, fresh water, or gold. The less there is of an item, the more it will cost. Your parents may notice that the price of gasoline for their cars can go up or down quite a bit. This is due to the amount of oil available to make the gasoline, an example of scarcity and supply and demand. Another thing that affects price is value. You may have heard adults ask if something is a good deal or worth the price. They're talking about the quality of the item they wish to buy. If something is being sold at a low price and is high quality, it has good value. Many things offered at low prices are not made well and are not a good value. Have you ever purchased an item at a good price only to have it fall apart on you the next day? That item was not a good value. So, you want to decide how to set a price on an item that you've designed for our marketplace. Here is a step-by-step way to help you set the best price for your item so that you will make a good profit, or scoops, or gold, and sell a lot of that item. Step 1. Determine demand. Ask yourself, what's selling? Take a look at the types of items that sell the most. Make note of the popular colors and designs that are selling well and what colors and designs may be missing. Do you notice the latest craze is pink and purple polka dots, but nothing in the marketplace has them? Hurry, make something! Step 2, determine scarcity. Look around the marketplace to see if a particular type of item doesn't have a lot of designs or no newer designs are being made. What items are selling well? What items could you help make newer designs for? Step 3, check prices. Once you know what you're going to make, see for what price items are selling. Some items may be priced high, but are not selling. A good target is to set your prices somewhere in the middle of the lowest price and the highest price. Step 4, create a good value. Make sure you're designing an item that you can be proud of and has good quality. The better your item is designed, the more time you take in creating it and making it look nice, the better the value it will have. Your customers will want more, and you'll feel good about making a high-quality product. I hope you've learned a lot about how setting prices works. Are you ready to create a fabulous, unique, and amazing design in our marketplace? Follow the steps in this video to make sure you're offering a quality product. Before you get selling, remember to practice what you've learned in our fun online games and quizzes. Good luck selling, and remember to always be clever.